Awake, ye men, from dreams of peace, nor sleep when danger's near. But fight Old Glory to the breeze. There are no cowards here. Our fathers fought like heroes died. For years their blood they gave. That honor, home, and peace be ours. Awake, thy country save. In 1917, President Wilson faced a huge challenge. How to get Americans to support the war. His 1916 presidential campaign slogan was, "He kept us out of the war." He needed arms. He needed equipment. And the military needed supplies. Most importantly, he needed to persuade isolationist Americans to invest in the war, financially by buying bonds, and emotionally by volunteering to serve, being patriotic, and sacrificing for the cause. Enter George Creel and the Committee on Public Information. Creel told Wilson he would create a vast enterprise in salesmanship, the world's greatest adventure in advertising. And he did. He created a division of pictorial publicity. Artist James Flagg created the now iconic Uncle Sam. Creel's goal was to reach everyone who could understand a picture. Posters were everywhere. Billboards, subway stations, sides of barns. Leaflets and pamphlets were sent to every home. And Creel created an army of public speakers. 75,000 four-minute men were hired to deliver patriotic speeches in movie theaters, union halls, churches, lodge meetings, and lumber camps. These speeches were especially focused on promoting support for the draft, the Red Cross, or food conservation, and of course, encouraging people to buy war bonds. Creel claimed four-minute men delivered over 7 million speeches to over 300 million people. Ladies and gentlemen, I have just received information that there is a German spy among us. A German spy is watching us. He is around somewhere, reporting upon you and me, sending reports about us to Berlin, and telling the Germans just what we are doing with the Liberty Loan. Attention, Mr. Farmer Man. You listen now to me, and I will try to show to you what I can plainly see. Your Uncle Sam, the dear old man who's been so good to you, is needing help and watching now to see what you will do. Creel also created a motion picture division. The British had been at war with Germany since 1914. They had effectively used film to reach the people. Many of the films presented alleged atrocities the Germans had perpetrated.
How about the Kaiser?
All right, brother, I'll put the question.
We made short work of the Kaiser. Nevermore will he reign on his throne. For they'll soon end his hope at the end of a rope, and the devil will say, welcome home. There's no doubt he's really in Dutch. I wish we had him in our clutch. All those in favor say aye.
Aye, 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 aye.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye, 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 aye.
He tried to take Paris as we all have seen. I make a motion, he takes Paris green. All those in favor say aye.
Aye,
The Division of Films did not call their work propaganda, for that word in German hands had come to be associated with lies and corruption. He said, "Our work was educational and informative only, for we had such confidence in our case as to feel that only fair presentation of the facts was needed." Creel secured an agreement with the Secretary of War to be the sole distributor of all motion pictures taken by the Signal Corps. I have called the Congress into extraordinary session because there are serious, very serious choices of policy to be made, and made immediately. To such a task, we can dedicate our lives and our fortunes, everything that we are and everything that we have, with the pride of those who know that the day has come when America is privileged to spend her blood and her might for the principles that gave her birth and happiness and the peace which she has treasured. God helping her, she can do no other. Richard Faulkner asks in his 2017 book, Pershing's Crusaders, "What was it like to be one of these foot soldiers at the dawn of the American century?" The Chicago Journal stated, "As a pictorial record of what America did to prepare for her share in the world conflict, the work cannot be excelled. It emblazons before its audience a picture of soldiery in the making so comprehensive and of such magnitude as to give a conception of our progress that is to be gained in no other way." The magnitude and the scope of the American effort to supply the soldiers is something to behold. What was it like for the doughboys to experience the rigors of training and of military life?